What's up, people? It's your girl Jen from BK. Here's your hot news of the week. Up at the station, Mike Epps stopped by and took some shots at Nick Cannon.
One thing about playing somebody like Richard Pryor, you have had to walk the walk to be able to play this role. You can't just jump up off of one of them. What show was that he was on? The Voice or what? America's Got Talent?
Yeah.
So you feel like Nick Cannon's fabric doesn't speak to what Richard Pryor's fabric is?
It really don't.
Chris Rock reveals an epic comedy tour that might be coming our way.
Me and Dave was talking about maybe doing something, you know? So we got to sit down, have that meeting.
I think you kind of stunting on us right there. You saw, you did the look around. We was kind of... We supposed to act like that didn't just happen, right?
We talk. We've been talking. We talk, you know. Like Pacino and De Niro in Heat. We sit at a booth.
In the latest episode of 97 Seconds, 50 Cent opens up about his brush with death.
I went through a portion of me actually being afraid and experienced, because I was hurt physically. I was hurt bad. So I was afraid and I was uncomfortable with being afraid.
Detroit Chase stops by Ladies First.
They never want to show up, but they begging us to show up. If you want the crew to come out, then you fucking gotta pay us.
Our monthly series, Who's Next, went down featuring Dej Loaf.
I leave a bitch nigga head imposter. You are an imposter, ain't got no money. I put that
Tommy and make it bubbly.
I really hate niggas, I'm a Nazi. Love wearing all black.
And things get super awkward between Ebro and K. Michelle.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking how you never put those lips on my Hot Pocket with that chin hair.
Oh, my
God.
See, now this thing just took a turn.
Here are your hot headlines. The Grammy nominations are in, and Beyonce is leading the pack with 5 nominations. That brings her to 47 Lifetime nominations, making her the most nominated female artist in Grammy history. Congratulations, B. Hip-hop royalty met real royalty when Beyonce and Jay-Z greeted Prince William and Kate Middleton at a Nets game. Our sister station, Power 106, held their Cali Christmas concert this past week, and it was there that Chris Brown revealed that he was single again.
I'm single too. That bitch.
Let's do it.
Chris took to social media and blasted Karrueche, saying that while he was in jail, she had threesomes and went on secret dates with Drake. Drake denied the whole thing, saying that Karrueche was not his type. And speaking of Drake, he was reportedly punched in the face by Diddy at Club Live over rights to a song. Ray J's manager claims he caught Young Berg in the studio in a compromising position with a teenage boy. Weezy confirms his issues with Birdman and Cash Money Records over his album not being released.
I'm fucked up in a bad situation, but I will be out of the zone and I do it for y'all.
Floyd Mayweather's best friend, Earl Hayes, shot his wife, VH1's Hit the Floor star, Stephanie Mosley, and then killed himself. Earl reportedly called Floyd before he did it to say his goodbyes. Apparently, the murder-suicide was over an alleged affair Stephanie had with Trey Songz. Nicki Minaj's The Pink Print album leaked, and Nicole Bitchy claims that she is dating Meek Mill. And finally, J. Cole's 2014 Forest Hills Drive is set to come in at number 1 on the Billboard 200 charts, and has sold an estimated 350,000 copies in its first week. All right, that's your Hot News of the Week. I'm your girl, Jen. Remember, to get a full recap of everything you saw today, head over to hot97.com. And while you're there, check out our top 20 moments of 2014. See you next week. Meek Millie's about to free that Willie.